Webb Telescope's first images of Mars just boosted Elon Musk plans. Webb focused its infrared camera on the Martian surface and atmosphere. The Webb Space Telescope has impressed us with photographs of far-off galaxies and gleaming nebulae, but it's also sent back its first pictures of Mars, our neighbor in the solar system. Scientists can learn more about Mars's surface and atmosphere thanks to the just-released data, which was collected by the telescope's infrared instruments. Let's find out what the JWST reveals of the planet Mars that boosted Elon Musk's plans in colonizing the red planet. Hello everyone and welcome back to Elon Musk Evolution, where we bring you the most recent news about Elon Musk and his multi-billion dollar companies. But before we begin, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click the bell icon so you don't miss out on any of our amazing videos. And let's begin! The James Webb Space Telescope's first photos in infrared spectra of Mars were made public by the European Space Agency. The first pictures in spectra of the red planet were taken by the Webb Telescope on September 5, 2022. Using the near-infrared camera and near-infrared spectrograph, the Webb Space Telescope saw Mars for the first time. It took two photos, each at a different infrared wavelength, to create this first image of Mars from the telescope. It displays a world with a sun-drenched eastern hemisphere, as well as one of the largest impact craters in the solar system and a lava flow from a long-extinct shield volcano. At the second Sun-Earth Lagrange point, or L2, Webb is located roughly 1.5 million kilometers from Earth. The area of Mars facing the telescope that receives sunlight is known as the observable disk, and it may be seen from the telescope's vantage point. As a result, JWST is able to take pictures and record spectra with the precise resolution required to research transient processes. Seasonal shifts, weather patterns, and dust storms are a few examples of these occurrences. The young planet Mars was struck by a massive object some 4 billion years ago, leaving a crater just south of the planet's equator that is 2,300 kilometers broad and 7 kilometers deep. In Webb's first image of Mars's eastern half, the crater, now known as Hellas Basin, is seen in dark orange. This colder spot contrasts with the remainder of the daylit side of the planet, which is illuminated by bright yellow heat radiation. The northeastern edge of the Hellas Basin and another of Mars's biggest craters, the 467-kilometer-wide Huygens crater, may both be seen in more detail when infrared light is at shorter wavelengths. A branching network of channels were etched into the stony surface when water was previously present in Huygens. Clay and carbonate materials, which only grow in moist conditions, were also discovered by NASA's Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter in Huygens, where a smaller impact crater had exposed them. A dark basalt flow from the long-extinct volcano Syrtis Major is located to the east of Huygens Crater. The landing site for the Perseverance rover is Jezero Crater, and it's located just southwest of the basalt plain. Near-infrared spectrograph was also used by Webb to gather some spectroscopic data on the Martian atmosphere. The spectrograph depicts some of the components that make up Mars's exceedingly thin atmosphere, such as carbon dioxide, water, and carbon monoxide, which correlate to the highlighted dips in the graph. Even if this isn't a groundbreaking result, it does demonstrate Webb's capacity to precisely analyze the atmospheric makeup of several worlds. Despite the fact that it may not seem amazing for a telescope that is meant to find far-off dim objects, it actually is. One of the brightest objects in the night sky, both in visible and infrared light, is Mars, which is relatively close to the Earth. Webb's instruments are so sensitive that the brilliant infrared light from Mars is practically dazzling, leading to a phenomenon called detector saturation, which is a problem. To get around this, scientists must utilize specialized detection methods, such as very brief exposure times and measuring only a portion of the light that reaches the detectors. They subsequently arrived at the image by utilizing unique data analysis techniques. The Mars Webb photos display variations in brightness over a wide range of wavelengths from location to location on the planet at a specific time and date. However, the spectrum shows how the planet as a whole is represented by the small brightness differences between thousands of various wavelengths. To learn more about the planet's surface and atmosphere, astronomers will examine spectrum features. According to Chris Evans, a Webb project scientist for the ESA, these first Webb observations of Mars indicate how we may examine the different regions on its surface, including the composition of its atmosphere with the NIR spec instrument. Webb will give us fresh insights into useful interpretations like the history of water on Mars, according to the statement. Building on what has been done with past missions and without the limits of Earth's atmosphere for ground-based spectroscopy. Scientists can determine how reliable the high-tech telescope is in observing extremely distant celestial planets by directing Webb's attention at a planet like Mars that has been extensively studied. We are excited to see new images of our cosmic neighborhood, like the latest sighting of a colorful Jupiter and its auroras, even while Webb continues to focus on objects all over the cosmos. And let's find out why new discoveries on Mars boost Elon Musk's plans in getting to Mars. Do you have what it takes to survive on Mars? Elon Musk recently stated that astronauts on the red planet may ultimately become a reality by 2029, so it may not be long before it actually happens. The CEO of SpaceX has had a long-held goal of building a settlement on Mars. 1 million people would live there, it would be self-sufficient, and it would make humanity a multi-planet species. It is possibly Musk's most audacious ambition and one that might keep him busy for the next 3 decades. On Mars's surface, Musk wants to construct an entire metropolis. It would be a metropolis accessible to everyone, not only academics and researchers. A loan may be used to cover the cost of a person's travel to Mars if they were interested. Once there, people would be able to pay back the loan by working in anything from pizza parlors to iron foundries. At a conference in 2016, Musk predicted that there would be a labor shortage for a very long time. The Starlink Internet Service terms and conditions, revealed in October 2020, indicate that this city would be able to govern itself on its own terms. This appears to be at odds with the 1967 Outer Space Treaty, which specifies that the country from where the launch originated is in charge of all subsequent space activities. The two papers may be headed for conflict, according to David Anderman, who was SpaceX's general counsel at the time the terms were published. He stated as much in a report published in 2021. The construction of a self-sustaining city on Mars, according to Musk's 2019 estimate, would require about 1 million tons of cargo. The cost of building a city on Mars would be close to $100 billion if freight transportation to Mars with the forthcoming Starship cost $100,000 per ton. According to Musk, the cost might reach $10 trillion on the highest end. But SpaceX might not end with one city. SpaceX's chief Mars development engineer, Paul Wooster, stated during the 21st International Mars Society Convention in August 2022 that the company may construct numerous cities. The concept would be to expand out, start off not just with an outpost, but grow into a larger base, not only like there are in Antarctica, but actually a village, a town, expanding into a city and eventually many cities on Mars, Paul stated. Elon Musk wants to create a metropolis on Mars, but for what reason? The transformation of humanity into a multi-planet species is Musk's stated goal. He has compiled a list of justifications for why people would want to spread out into the cosmos over the years. He frequently mentions the idea that a catastrophe on Earth could mean the end of civilization, but that if it can establish a foothold on another planet, like Mars, humanity may survive. Being a spacefaring civilization, in my opinion, is one of the things that gets you thrilled about the future. There are a lot of factors that make people unhappy or depressed about the future, Musk explained. And that's it for today, guys. We sincerely hope you enjoyed our video. If you did, please click on the like button and share with your friends and family. And you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to see even more of our incredible videos. Hey, we'll catch up with you in the next one. Thanks for watching!